Hi, I'm Mike Armstrong.
Cheers. They're pretty interesting, aren't they?
I think so.
Take this one for example. It's big, blue, and in the middle of this courtyard. But I know a chair that's even more interesting. Her name is Dr. Noda Clencher. She's a Chancellor Research Chair here at Brock University. Her research in muscle physiology is going to be the subject of today's focus.
I'm in the Applied Physiology Lab with Dr. Noda Clencher. Noda, you just became the new Associate Dean for Graduate Studies in the Faculty of Applied Health Sciences.
Right.
Can you tell me a little bit about that role?
Well, basically, we have researchers in wet labs doing very basic mechanistic work to sociologists that use most qualitative methodology. So because it's such a diverse and interdisciplinary also program, I connect the dots and mm-hmm. try to facilitate the experience of the students.
So obviously you're really passionate about your work. I know you won an award, I think in 2009, a Chancellor's Research Award.
Yes.
Can you tell me a little about your research that you did to win that award?
Well, my research is in the pediatric exercise science, so I study the effects of training on health and performance in younger individuals, meaning children and adolescents. So that's the focus of the lab as a whole. Now, the latest research projects we have is the Brock Active Muscles, which is mainly a project with Brackett Falk. Dr. Falk is the principal investigator, and it's basically a longitudinal evaluation of neuromuscular activation in children. Now, I'm piggybacking on hers, and I'm doing also a longitudinal analysis of the growth and development of bone in interaction with the growth and development of muscles. So we try to see which one goes first, which drives the growth, which drives the development, the adaptation to training, exercise, nutrition, so on and so forth. So we are looking into the life of the interaction between muscle and bone.
So Noda, can you tell me exactly what this machine does and what it's looking to measure?
Yes, this is a quantitative bone ultrasound, basically, and it's an easy and inexpensive and very safe way for measuring bone quality, bone properties. And we use that because we, both myself and Dr. Falk, we measure bone strength in children. So every other traditional method involves radioactive, like X-rays. So this is a preferable way to do it because it doesn't involve the same radioactivity. So it's an ultrasound, and basically it measures peripheral bone, the speed of sound through the bone or across the bone, which also it's interesting because it takes into account size because it's across the bone, not through. Okay. And what it does is basically measures the speed of sound. Faster the sound it is, more bone is there, and the quality of bone is also assessed or reflected in a way. So we can measure either the distal radius with this probe or the tibia. So both peripheral bones, and actually the tibia is also very, very interesting because when we exercise, this is where we apply more forces, even when we walk. So the bones adapt with physical activity, and therefore we expect them to be stronger, especially the dominant one, as also the dominant hand versus the non-dominant. So that's an easy way for measuring bone properties.
All right, so I'm here with Isabella Ludwa. That's correct, right?
Yes.
Okay. Can you tell me what program you're in?
I'm in the PhD program in the Faculty of Applied Health Science, and I work under the supervision of Dr. Noda Clentru.
Did you do your master's here as well?
I did, yes, also with Dr. Clentru in the Faculty of Applied Health Science.
What got you interested to do your PhD here?
I think it's a really great program. It allows for a lot of collaborative work, and I've always really been interested in doing research in youth, and I have the opportunity to do that when I work with Dr. Clentru.
This is a machine that you use for your research. Can you tell me a little bit about what it does?
This is an ultrasound machine, so it's the same kind of machine that if a woman was pregnant and she was going to go get an image of the fetus, but we use it to look at muscle. So with a lot of the research that we do here, we look at growth and development in children and adolescents, and I'm interested in the connection between muscle and bone. So I look to see how strong the muscle is in the arm here as well as the bone in the forearm. And when I want to look at the connection between the two, I want to take into account how big the muscle is around the bone and also how strong it is. So we can use the ultrasound here to take a picture of the muscle like you see here. Mm-hmm. And then what we can do is see how big that muscle is. So I can take a measurement from the top of the bone all the way up to the top of the muscle to see how big it is and kind of get an area of the muscle to see if someone, if they have a bigger muscle and that might apply larger forces to the bone, does that mean then that the bones will be stronger?
Okay. Do you think you really need a machine to see that I have big muscles, or does that even need to be tested?
Well, it does, because children grow at different rates and at different sizes. So just because a child is bigger doesn't necessarily mean that that muscle that is bigger is going to be able to apply more forces. So when we take a measurement of how strong that muscle is, we kind of can then take into account how big that muscle is, so we can correct for the size of the muscle so that we can compare children of different sizes.
So I got one last question for you today, and that is, what is on the other side of your brain? I know you have passion in the lab. What's on the outside?
That's interesting. I would say, I spent most of my youth as an international rhythmic gymnast. I've been in the organizing committee for 2004 Olympic Games. So I would say cultural events and sports events and volunteering in the sports events and try to make physical activity become a means to develop youth around the world, because I travel a lot with the International Gymnastics Federation, trying to use sports and gymnastics in developing countries to make the lives of kids better and fun. I think that's the other side of my brain, more humanitarian, more spread the sports around the world and use it as a means to make kids happy.
So at Brock University, we keep you jumping through hoops. And on the other side, you got the gymnastics background to do it.
And I do jump through hoops.
That's all the time we have for today. But if you're interested in learning about more research going on in the Faculty of Applied Health Sciences, you can find us at... I'm Mike Armstrong, and you are now out of focus.